Next to Champa was Magadha. We have to keep in mind that Magadha was initially a weaker power, but with the coming of the Mauryas, it was Magadha who actually controlled the entire Indian subcontinent. So it became, the power of Magadha became a pan-Indian power. Just prior to 6th century BC, the Magadhan ruler was the family of Brihadratha. But from 6th century BC, we have a new family ruling in Magadha, and this was the Haryanka family. This Haryanka family is very important in Indian history because its first ruler was Bimbisara, who was a very important military leader and an astute politician. When we were talking about this different confrontations between the different powers, we have to keep in mind that different kinds of interactions happened between these powers. And these powers were often engaged in military conflicts, in truce, and also in dynastic marriages. So for Bimbisara, who was a very astute politician, he could realize that on ascending the throne, just embarking upon aggrandizement or waging a war would not suit his purpose, because he knew that in comparison to other powers, Magadha was a weaker power. So the first step he took was to contract dynastic marriages between Madra in West Punjab and getting the Koshalan princess as his wife. And this changed actually the economy of Magadha and the politics also, because the Koshalan prince brought the Kashi village, the Kasi Gamo, as a dowry for Bimbisara. So thus Bimbisara could control a part of the Kasi region, which, as mentioned earlier, was a very important region of that time. Now, with the control of Kashi and Western Punjab and having the major powers as an ally, Bimbisara embarked upon the conquest of Anga. This was the first step in his policy of expansion towards the east. Thus, the control of Champa and the possession of Kashi gave him a very strong footing, and with that he started on his expansionist policy. Bimbisara's expansionist policy was very helpful for his son Ajatashatru, who was more aggressive and more dynamic. He wanted to get hold of Avanti. Avanti was located in the western part of the Indian subcontinent with its capital in Ujjaini. As we know that Ujjaini was also a very important trade center. It was a very important, located on a very important trade route that ran from Pratishthana to northern part, and also it was linked with the coastal parts of Gujarat. So control of Ujjaini was very important.